Yeah.
This is not happening. I told you it's not gonna work with my wife. It's huge. I can't even get it back to what was my
What is that supposed to
be? They are a human. I can't do this
interview. I am not even qualified to sit here.
What is happening? I know. I should say that, no.
You can't face your wife? You can't face your wife? Chaitanya, 2 minutes, Chaitanya. Just.
Take a break.
Take a break, chill. My.
What's going on?
Nothing. You've done 24 of this, come on.
I've never done with my wife.
Now that Chaitanya has once again given up and he has sort of run away from or has fallen back, fallen behind Rajani, Pawan has asked me to take this responsibility and continue with this Runner's High interview. Welcome Rajani.
Hi, thank you.
Runner's High.
Thank you. And congratulations on your Malnad Ultra.
Thank you very much. I know it is only because I ran with you one Sunday.
Yes. I am willing to take credit.
I know what the Chota Guru used to do in Hillside with running history. So tell us how it started.
The running journey or the fitness journey?
Running journey, let's do.
Well, before I started running, I used to walk. I walked for 10 years because I had put on weight and I decided that I need to do something about it. But the running journey started actually when we moved to Pebble City. So we moved and Chaitanya and I used to go for walks. And one day after one of these walks, we were stretching in the lawns in Pebble. And you came actually to us and taught us some stretches and asked us to join the runners group. And you told us that you guys meet at 5 a.m. And that's what it was. But when I heard 5 a.m., I decided it's not my cup of tea.
Okay.
But then I don't know. I think we decided to give it a shot and we started doing it. And that's about how it started.
And how far has it gone?
From then? Okay, 2015 is when we started and I've done several half marathons since then. I have done one 25k run and now I'm training to do a full marathon, which I hope to do sometime within this year.
You also spoke about a fitness journey being different than running journey. So
see, running is a part of fitness. Fitness can be anything. It could be running, it could be dancing, it could be walking. It's something you do to go out, exercise and stay fit.
So tell us about that fitness journey as well in case.
Yeah, the fitness journey, like I said, started in 2005 actually. Before that in school, I used to be in athletics and I used to enjoy it. But then once I started working, everything sort of took a backseat to work. And we lived in Japan for some time and work was everything for almost 10 years. And somewhere in 2005, I had put on a lot of weight and I used to also not have any energy. Even to walk 5 steps, I used to be like, oh, I'm tired, I don't want to walk, I want to take a cab. Those used to be the excuses I used to make. And Chaitanya used to say that we should do something or you should do something about it, go out, do something. I kept ignoring him as usual, but...
That's a wise thing.
But once the weighing scale hit a certain number, that was a wake-up call.
And you won't share that number?
Well, I don't mind. For me, 70 is that number, being 70 kgs. Yeah, for me. That sort of scared me. I said, if I'm going to cross 70, it can go to 80, it can go to anything. Right? So I decided ki enough is enough. And with Chaitanya's help, actually, we started walking. It used to be first, maybe we used to do 0.5 kilometer and come back. Slowly it went to 3 kilometers. And eventually I started walking 7-8 kilometers a day. That's how my fitness journey started. And I also started watching what I eat. I lost some weight. Again, I would sort of fall off the wagon and go back to being lazy. Again, I would sort of again say, okay. I mean, it was an up and down cycle and I kept doing it. But at the end, yeah.
But once you got into running, then it seems to have stabilized.
Running has been more stable. I've been very consistent. I think it's because of the group. More than, because this was only us, both of us. And there was, I mean, beyond just walking so many kilometers, there was no other motivation. There was nothing. Whereas here you say, okay, when you're running, you want to do something. You say you want to do a half marathon, you do it. Then you say, okay, let me do something else. Why not try a 25K? I mean, you can set small goals, move fast, and that keeps you inspired.
I also know, though I'm not even able to follow it much, but you pay a lot of attention to the kind of food and the amount of food you would eat.
Yeah.
So what role has food played in this entire journey?
In the running journey?
In a fitness journey, running journey. Yeah.
So we started running, like I said, in 2015. And in 2016, we decided to try the Maffetone method,
mm-hmm.
both for running and for diet.
Mm-hmm.
So for running, we started running at a heart rate. Mm-hmm. I'm sure, I don't want to go into technicalities. A lot of people know about it. For diet, we decided that we will drop processed food completely,
mm-hmm.
and sugar. Mm-hmm. So we cut sugar completely from our teas, coffees, or everything, and we stopped eating processed food, increased our fat intake.
Mm-hmm.
So we've been eating like a lot of ghee or paneer or white butter. Our coffee, actually our morning coffee is dark black coffee with white butter.
Mm-hmm.
And that was one of the biggest changes that we made. The impact was initially I lost weight, which is a feel good in itself.
Mm-hmm.
And I also started noticing that I don't feel hungry all that much.
Mm-hmm.
That actually curbed my, you know, this thing that I have to eat more.
Mm-hmm. And the energy levels?
I think energy levels, maybe, I don't know if, I mean, I didn't notice a big change.
Mm-hmm.
But what I did notice was the tendency to eat had reduced.
Mm-hmm.
And the cravings to eat sugar or sweets, that had gone completely.
Mm-hmm. So
that is the impact it has had. And I feel healthier, happier, and thinner.
That's a great motivation.
Yeah.
Both of you work pretty hard on food and stretchings, and you also seem to do a lot of cross training in terms of yoga. So
something I don't enjoy, but yeah.
You don't enjoy, but you still do that.
I enjoy running.
Mm-hmm.
I like yoga because I think it is necessary, but I find it difficult.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not a flexible person by mm-hmm. body structure and all that, so it's a lot of effort.
Mm-hmm.
And I also know that it is important because it helps me with my running, so mm-hmm. I do it.
So you do it because it's good for running?
Yes.
Okay.
Don't tell my yoga teacher I said that.
If you don't want to hear them, then you shouldn't tell.
Yeah.
Tell us about how yoga, you practice yoga, so how yoga helps in running and fitness journey.
Inherently, my job is a sitting job. So mm-hmm. I sit at a chair for 8 hours a day.
Mm-hmm.
So I think that is the cause for me to have a lot of stiffness in my body.
Mm-hmm.
So I have stiff back, I have stiff hamstrings, I have a lot of stiff muscles. So when, sometimes when I run, I have back catches, or sometimes the legs arrest. So I have been injury prone. So what mm-hmm. I have been seeing is with yoga and stretching, the tendency to get injured is less. And even if I do get injured, it helps me recover faster from my injury.
Mm-hmm.
That's how yoga is helping me. Mm-hmm. It's also helping me build strength. Like yoga also involves a lot of core strength exercises and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
So those are the two things, flexibility and strength.
So what next in terms of running journey then?
My first full marathon, of course.
Mm-hmm. And what is the kind of preparation you're doing for that? And
okay, I started training for this in April. I've been planning to do it. I wanted to do it this year. Incidentally, I'm 42. So I want to do 42 while I'm 42. I don't mind my age being out there. So I started training in April, and I've been training consistently, I hope.
Mm-hmm.
I've done several 28Ks, 25Ks, 232Ks. And I'm hoping that I shall be ready soon. But I don't mm-hmm. want to put a date to it, because I did put a date. I wanted to do it in the Bangalore Marathon, but something's derailed my plans.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm just taking it easy.
Well, that's fine.
Yeah, I have another 6 months till I turn 43. Yeah.
We have run several times together. So while running, what are your thought process? What do you do? You chart. A lot of people chart. A lot of people don't speak.
I'm not much of a speaker when I run.
Uh-huh.
I listen. If somebody's talking to me, I listen. Otherwise, I don't mind running by myself also, lost in thoughts. What I enjoy is the morning, the freshness mm-hmm. and the sunrises, which I've probably in my entire life I wouldn't have seen as many sunrises as I did in these 3 years.
Mm-hmm.
I enjoy just the process of running. That's it.
But you don't like dogs there?
That topic, no. I don't like dogs.
You don't like dogs?
No, I don't like dogs, and I'm scared of them.
So what happens when you see a dog?
Do we need to go there?
Yeah, I mean, there are no dogs here. So you can at least discuss them.
First reaction is fear.
Uh-huh.
And if the dog follows me, it's irritation, annoyance. Uh-huh. And in rare cases, and let me tell you, pretty rare, uh-huh. there are tears too.
Rare? I've seen you twice already.
Hello.
And we don't run that often.
That means you're telling me that I'm running and crying more often than I'm running.
I mean, I am there.
But that's because probably you carry that dog with you.
I don't carry those dogs. Those dogs follow me.
Whatever it is, the dog is around you. That's
right. Yeah, dogs are. So what would you do if a dog chases you? How fast would you run?
I don't know. I mean, as fast as I can, of course.
Or you want to stand still there?
I think I would run.
You would run?
I know it's not right, but I would run. No, but luckily nowadays when I run, I have friends who are
more dog friendly.
Dog friendly, or at least they know how to handle them. So. Mm. Friends and Chaitanya, of course, also. Mm. You too.
I remember, bring them.
No, but you did avoid running and coming back for us once to make sure that the dogs don't come. So I have good friends.
You're good friends.
Yes.
And we also know that you are the brand ambassador for the Hyderabad Ultra Marathon.
Yes.
So tell us what is there in store for runners.
For the ultra marathon?
Yes.
Well, it's a challenging route, excellent support, and a lovely breakfast at the end of it.
That's what a runner,
and that's what a runner wants.
Yeah. So what's your role there? I mean, so what's your role as a brand ambassador there?
Basically promote the event and make sure everybody hears about it and wants to participate in it.
I mean, you are anyways the ambassador. I mean, in PCR you have promoted runs and otherwise.
Yeah, it's an extension.
You guys
to
went
that.
To Pune for some time, and there also you participated in runs and you were very active in running.
Yes,
in Pune.
Yes,
as well.
Yes.
So how is Hyderabad versus Pune in terms of running and running culture?
Running culture is, I guess, both cities, it's a very active culture. But in Pune, I think the focus has always been on speed.
Okay.
People, at least that's my, again, it's my personal opinion. I don't know if it's true. Typical people's goals are speed goals.
Mm-hmm.
Whereas what I've noticed in Hyderabad is people probably prefer a distance goal.
Mm-hmm.
Like if somebody's on a 21, they would probably want to do a 42 or you know, up their distance.
Mm-hmm.
Pune, they would say, okay, if I've done 21 in X time, I might want to do 21 in X minus so many hours. I mean, that's my understanding of it. But otherwise, the culture's pretty much the same. I guess runners in world over are pretty much the same. It's about encouraging running and spreading the spirit.
I'm sort of done with a part of the interview, but now I would request Rajani if I could introduce the hero. And I would also request Pawan if you could escort the hero onto the stage. We know, So welcome, Chaitanya.
Thank you.
I hope you're comfortable as well. Is that really
it's
hot
a,
seat or?
It's a bit hot.
Excuse me.
Tell us, she has shared the couple running journey, but if there is anything that you would want to add on your own as Chaitanya.
About her.
Not about your journey.
Hello.
Personally, I don't have a running journey per se. Like, I've been running as many years as she has, or probably as few years as she has. But it's not like I enjoy or don't enjoy running. I run because it's now a part of life. I just wake up in the morning, I have to go running. And mentally, I'm a little researchy type. So for me, every day is like, okay, aaj ye karke dekhte, wo karke dekhte. So I think as of now, I've found enough new things to do about my running to keep me excited for 4 years. Hopefully, I'll find more.
Yeah, I know, I mean, that we have discussed many times that you're very data driven and you record a lot of stuff, both about running, food.
Yeah, he's calculated the calories we need.
Yes.
In a run.
Per hour,
per minute.
I've also seen those weighing machines kept on the table, weighing utensils as well.
Yeah,
so
he makes these math cookies with almond and cocoa.
I know,
they are like
nice ones.
Oh, they are to die for. They're making my long runs like the most expected thing in a week.
Yes. No, but you tell us about what, why this so focus on, you said you're a researchy type, but still, what is it?
It's about the fact that I know I started too late in my life running. I mean, I used to sprint in school. I used to be pretty fast. I mean, even now I think I can be reasonably fast in my age group. Like if I race, I think I might do pretty well. But for a long distance runner, I don't think my lifestyle suits it. As much as I try, I can do half marathons, but beyond that, my lifestyle doesn't match it. Like, I cannot do that. So I know there is a limit to what I can achieve, a limit to what speeds I can achieve. Next best thing I can do is find out what else can be done within my limits. Like, I have so much time to spare. So if I change my food, what happens? If I change my running style, what happens? If I change my shoes, what happens? So this is my running. I wake up every day finding out, achha, ye naya karke dekhte hai. And sometimes it works, sometimes it really messes me up. So, yeah,
So two transitions that I have seen, I mean, in both of you, in terms of food and shoes, that you have gone from something which is really full to something which is very minimalistic.
Yeah.
So tell us about that, this approach towards minimalism.
For her, I think it's a change, minimalist. For me, that is my natural state, because I have tended to be a person who walks without chappal from school, college, kahin bhi. And shoes are kind of an impediment. Like, pehna padta hai toh, but when somebody said, no, you can run without shoes, I'm like, this is an opportunity, nikalte, dekhte hai, joote. And coincidentally, around the time when I was excited about not running with shoes, Satish had bought these new kind of
zero sandals.
I said, okay, ye toh kharid ke dekhte hai. And again, the cost was a factor, like it has to come from the US. And I said, okay, let's experiment, let's buy the cheapest one. So I bought the DIY one. Again, something that I wanted to try and find out.
Seriously.
Okay, and that turned out to be a good experiment because it worked well, my feet feel better. And when I did my Mumbai this year, around the 17-18K mark, the chappal actually broke. So actually had to carry it in my hand and run, which made me feel very nice. So from that day, for about 5 months, I kept running without footwear.
Barefoot, yeah.
So it was not a transition, I just changed overnight. And it worked for a lot of time, but then it also hurt me. So eventually I had to say, okay, it doesn't work on this thing. So I went back to those chappal. So yeah, for me, that's a natural state. I feel happiest. Even if I'm coming out of the apartment in Pebble, I think I'll be one of the odd guys who will be walking out of the
barefoot. And in terms of food also, you have had a drastic shift.
Oh yeah, that for me is a drastic shift. I am a big time, I love sweets.
He loves sweets, yeah.
But it has paid off.
It's paid off. I don't know if it has paid off for my running, but it's paid off on my health, because very, very commonly I used to have a lot of tummy troubles. I mean, tummy would pain, I'd have acidity issues, lots of funny problems. And from the day I've started 2 years ago to now, I think there were about 4 or 5 episodes in 2 years where I've had an acid problem or anything. So basically all this have disappeared.
I think even our tendency to catch colds has come down. It has come down.
I think after in 2 years, I probably had like 4 colds.
Yeah, whereas before we used to be down with a cold.
Very frequently.
Very frequently.
I can associate each of my colds this year with a bout of sugary tea.
Come on. You have data for that also.
I have data for that.
Oh, yes.
So I know, okay, I ate sweets, so many sweets in a week or two, I have a cold.
I have cold.
And I can actually, it's been correlating. So it could be a coincidence. Because it's not enough data.
This is not scientific, but it's our experience.
It's not sufficient data to say, yeah, because sugar khaya to sardi hua.
And other than running, I've also seen both of you contributing a lot in terms of the running community or community in general. I mean, I've seen it in AHM, of course. You guys are devoted to the registration and backend team of, I've seen you working day in, day out on laptops and making sure that all the registrations go through. People get all the emails and stuff. In PCR run as well, I've seen you working on that. And then again, across all HMs for last 3 years at least, 2 years.
2 years, 2 years, 2017 and 18. Yeah.
What does this mean? I mean, why so much?
I don't know. When we started running also, all the people who helped us, we never paid for it, right? It all came free, all the advice, all the training. Everything was free. Everybody just helps each other. So why not give back? I think that is the seed of this whole thing.
I mean, you have gone even beyond that. I mean, every Tuesday, Thursday, you will actually come down.
The strength training,
and the
strength training sessions.
The leg strength.
It actually works for my good because I feel responsible. I go out, otherwise I might be sleeping. I don't know. So it works for my good also. Like, it might look like I'm doing some great service, but actually it's my good.
No, actually it is a great service. And I would say that a lot of people have benefited out of it. Because one, it gives them structure, and it gives them, like you say, a data-driven structure. You know what, how much stretch and stuff like that.
I think that also, I think, came from Pune. They used to do this.
Okay.
The runners there would do this. We used to have these Tuesday, Thursday strength training sessions, and somebody would come and do it like this, like he does. Somebody would do it. And I think that culture, and we learned those training, the stretches and the exercises there, and he just incorporated it here.
And now I am reminded that I was the one who introduced you to stretching.
Yes, so you can take the credit.
You can take the whole thing. For me, an eye opener, because by then, her memory for this for a change was wrong. Because we didn't start running in Kerala.
How?
We didn't start running in Kerala. We started running when we were in Kundapur.
Mm. Okay.
I forgot that.
We used
that.
To go to the stadium to run.
Hello, we used to go to walk.
To walk. Uh-huh. And our greatest achievement in 6 months was to do 2 rounds of that 400 meter track.
Okay.
We were kings of our building. Right.
And we were super proud of the whole thing because in the whole apartment, nobody could do that.
Okay.
Right, and we come here and...
Everybody is talking about 5 kilometers, 8 kilometers. That was early days, right? Uh-huh. But Archana used to go to second, third gate and we were like, we used to manage to come to Himayat Sagar first gate and say, bus ho gaya.
And we managed to do that. Like, I think a week or so we did it. But it was not a good experience. Because we used to come back home and feel horrible.
Mm-hmm.
And that day when you met us and made us do those stretches, like, we realized we went home and like, oh,
it felt different.
Why is it so different today? So it's...
Yes.
That is really easy.
So every Tuesday morning you'll announce this.
Well, it's caught on tape.
No, people may not watch it, so you announce it. Tuesday, Thursday morning before you start the exercise. The genesis of this is that day, early morning when we came back from the run.
I think that's the... I don't know.
No, for us it is because Satish was very keen that we stretch.
Satish made you stretch, you made me stretch. We are making somebody else
stretch. And so the chain continues.
It just has to go on that way. End of the day, I think if somebody says, what did you achieve? Yeah, this is what we achieved. We got one more person to run.
So from your own running experience, both good and bad, if you have to give a piece of running advice to runners, or would-be potential runners, would-be runners, current runners, what would you say?
I'll talk about my personal experiences during races. So, like I told you, 2015, AHM was my first half marathon. I ran with everything. I put everything into it. I had an injury. I still put everything into it and I finished. But after I finished, for about an hour, I could not see anything. Mm-hmm. I had like spots in front of my eyes and I think it was because of low sugar. At that point, I didn't even know what it was.
Mm-hmm.
Eventually, after eating something, I think I started to see, but it took an hour. It was not very quick. 2016, an year later, same thing. Maybe it was 20 minutes, but still the same thing. I thought maybe it was less training in 2015 that caused it. But from 2015 to 2016, I trained quite a bit. Despite that, I had those spots.
Mm.
Over time, I figured out that I was not eating anything through the race.
You're not having enough
nutrition.
I was
not having no nutrition, nothing at all actually. Mm. I would not eat because it was, how can I eat and run?
Mm.
You know, that thought used to be there in my mind. So I figured that out and I started eating. I started stopping at aid stations, eating. I noticed that firstly I could run faster.
Mm-hmm.
My biggest fear in stopping was I would lose out on time.
Lose out on time.
You know, because I had this time goal, the typical runner, this thing. Okay, so I said, okay, if I lose out on time, I'll not get what time, the time I want. So I would not eat.
Mm.
But when I started eating, I found that even though I took those 3-4 minutes off to stop and eat, I could sort of speed up and also I finished feeling stronger.
Mm-hmm.
And after that, I've run many half marathons and I've not had those blackout episodes.
Mm-hmm.
I finished feeling strong, I finished feeling good. So the
nutrition during the race.
Yeah, during the race, you should eat, especially if you're doing beyond 10 kilometers, you must eat and must drink water.
Must drink water.
Must drink your salts, everything. Because even though cramping has not been a personal experience of mine, I've had friends who've had those problems. So salts and water and food
is important.
That's
during the race also.
During the race. During training, we do slow training. So, I mean, nutrition does not play a very big role when you're running.
Unless
slow.
You have those cookies.
Yeah, no, those cookies are... I wake up in the morning on Sundays for that.
Now that you picked up the cookies, so this is one advice to anybody who listens to anybody who's saying runner, running is not expensive. Those cookies are expensive. We spend a bomb when making those cookies.
You spend a bomb.
I enjoy it.
And she
enjoys the fruits.
That is enough reward for you. Anything else, and from a running point of view, any advice?
I've not run that much that I should be able to advise people, but I can tell you what my philosophy is. Philosophically, if you're happy with the way I think, you could pick it up. Don't create a goal because your friend has a goal.
Mm-hmm.
It's all great. Like you achieve something, you can talk about it for 6 months, after that nobody cares. Create a goal because you have certain health targets in your life. Want to feel better, put those as your goals.
Mm.
Now, I can always take pressure. My wife is training for 42. I want to do 42. I know it. I cannot do it. Physically, maybe I can do it.
I think he can, but he's...
But my lifestyle doesn't match it. Mm-hmm. And I think that is something you have to understand about your own running goals, to be happy about your running. I enjoy what I do. I don't care what anybody else does. So, it's, I think that's a good thing to have in your life. Right? And it also helps that there's a lot of pressure at home and you're trained not to worry about it.
So welcome to Rapid Fire. Chaitanya, your turn. So what is the running supply you use the most?
Water.
Rajani, what's your favorite pet name?
Pet name?
Pet's name.
I don't have pets. I don't like pets.
If Rajani has to wear a Halloween costume.
This is a tough one. There's quite a few that I can think of, but I think slightly controversially, not so nice, but I'd like to see her in Cersei's costume.
Why Cersei?
And if he has to be a superhero, which one?
Spider-Man.
One habit of hers that annoys you the most?
There must be many.
One of them. Let's start with one.
So annoys me, right?
Yes.
Yeah, the fact that I have to stick to schedules.
Uh-huh.
By mistakes, I have to run 10 kilometers, I have to run 10 kilometers, yeah. And she'll make me do it.
Target is target.
Target is target. And one habit that you like?
About him,
yes.
Running? That he keeps the slowest runner company.
Japan or Kenya?
Japan.
Any day.
From a running point of view, Japan or Kenya?
Still Japan.
Japan.
Still Japan?
Yeah.
One talent other than running that Chaitanya has?
He has many. Making my cookies.
Any special abilities he has?
I don't know, his technical skills are very good, work-wise and all that. I really admire his design skills when it comes to work.
About her? One talent other than running or making you work?
It's something I like and I am not very happy about is her ability to sing.
If I were to buy a gift for her?
I think it would be a chocolate.
What would you do?
Minimalistic chappal.
For feet?
For feet.
Of course, okay. that used to be college when a boy gives chocolates.
Actually, you know what? To be honest, I think electronic stuff, he loves gadgets.
Hmm.
Gadgets of any kind. It doesn't have to be running related.
Okay. I thought you're going back to campus, college campus. Boy comes over and gives you chocolate and you give him chocolate.
No, I meant more like, okay, if it's a serious answer, gadgets.
Gadgets.
He loves them.
And what's your favorite running memory?
Goa.
I think it's always Goa.
Mm. Goa.
I know, he keeps talking about Goa all the time, actually.
During run, post run.
Post, during. For me, I think I want to go to Goa every year to do a run. And only a 10K.
Run. 10K run there.
Just to do a 10K.
Uh-huh.
I just love the place.
So what's the most embarrassing thing which has happened while running?
Crying when I see a dog, obviously.
For you? Seeing her crying?
No, actually, that scares me. I don't know how to handle it on the road. I think that also was embarrassing the last time it happened.
Hmm.
Because I was running next to her. Yes.
On the nursing fire.
She's crying and I'm like trying to console her and the police guy is like...
Why are you answering her?
Yeah, or I'm like... <Do anything.
laughs> So if you dream about running, what is that?
Dream in the sense, in what?
When you're
sense?
Sleeping, when you dream about running, what are you dreaming about?
I would love to run in Japan, actually. That was in my mind. I want to run under the sakura blossoms. I want to run in the fall colors.
Okay. In Japan?
Yeah.
And you just want to be there?
I just love the country. So, yeah. But I do dream, but those are like out of the world. I've actually competed in about 7 full marathons with Kipchoge.
And he lost in 6 of them.
We are close now.
That's a dream to have. Of course, that's
it. Is definitely.
I mean, we say agar sapne mein roti khani hai to beta dono taraf ghee laga ke khao. Why just run in Japan? I mean, I'm going to beat Kipchoge there.
I have realistic dreams.
Thank you very much. It is a pleasure.
Thank you.
Action.
I hope you like today's episode.
Please start.
I hope. Come on. I hope you like today's episode. This episode was brought to you by these lovely people. Yeah.
Respectfully.
This.
ये लोग नहीं, ये लोग. So you're trying to reference the Shailendra. You don't have to.
No, I'm not. I'm just referencing something there.
This. That's it. This.
Okay. I hope you liked today's episode. This episode was brought to you by these lovely people. Please do like, share and subscribe to our channel. See you next time. Are we done now?
Done, sir. Let the professionals do the whole thing now. Hope you enjoyed the episode today. This episode was brought to you with support from all these wonderful people. Please like, share and subscribe to our channel and see you next time.